Hello everyone, this is another Abacus tutorial. This tutorial is renovation of concrete columns. So in this tutorial we will string an existing columns. So this is the existing columns which has a section 30 by 30 centimeters, and we consider a very typical and simple model which has four rebars in four corners. And we then added a new layer, which is called jacketing, concrete jackets or jacketing method. And then we provided a large reinforcement, again, for simple stages four, and we increased the thickness of the concrete to 50 centimeters. So in the first step, we have 13, and the renovation part or the straining part, we have 50 centimeters total. And we assume in both 2 centimeters clear cover. And for existing, when you reach the fit, so you must consider a gap between the existing material and also the new material that should have a high compressive strength. So the available is 15. We wanna make it a little high changes, and that can show some more impacts. And the last one is 30 megapascal. So we're using the same method for the steel. We're using steel for the existing 235 megapascal for the yellow string, and for the renovated or retrofitted rebar, we will use 345 megapascal. We will divide this in the two tutorial videos. So the first we will model this one from scratch, and the second we will add this one again. So we jump to the Abacus software. We go through to the modeling, and first we can call it existing column. So, and remember that the length of the column we assume is 3 meters. We use the deformable solid elements, and we're using method extrusion. The unit we want to use is millimeter, so that can be quite easy. 0, 0. Two value, you did not that required three values, and 0, 0. And the last one is we take this point and we to up by 300 millimeters in the Y and 300 millimeter in the X and 300 millimeter in the Y. So exactly here is the center, which make us easier to model the column. Now we double click or just click, say done, and we give the length 3000 millimeter. Now this is the concrete part. And the second part is going to be a rebar. I can call it existing rebar, so that EA represents the existing structure. We have two options to create rebar. One is we can use wire, and also we can use the solid elements. For the solid element, that we can consider some cohesive behavior between concrete, and that's also very logical and practical, but it takes some time. Well, maybe in the next tutorial we'll discuss this as well. And deformable wire and the same, and I can give a line to 0, 0, and the length should be we want to reduce this length, and considering 2960, which is about less than equal to the edge side, 2 centimeters, and totally 4 centimeters or 40 millimeters reduced. Now the rebar is also created. Next, I wanna create E stirrups. Stirrups is like this, and then we give again 0, 0, and The same things we will reduce in both side. Both side. If I okay, that's okay. We're considering 2 centimeters one side. So totally has 300. So then we will go 260 by 260. So this is the existing straps. The second part is properties, and we will create the material. The first called existing steel, and the properties is we can use the density, and the density is 2 cubic millimeters. So it should be 0. So it should be 7.85 e minus 9, which is almost using in turn. So like this, and we go to the elasticity, and we use elastic modulus is 200 and 1000. This is megapascal. Megapascal 0.3, and for the plasticity, just we give plastic, and the yield strength is 235, which is equal 0. And so we considering just this one, the yield point, and we're not putting more data for yield strength and ultimate strength as well, or even we can add one more and maximum. This sort of this still is a Q steel 235, which is has almost 375 megapascal ultimate strength, which is equal 0.80% plastic strength. So this is a approximate number. In case if you have some experimental data, you can put it here. So I'm gonna call okay. And the second one is concrete material. So in my library, I have some concrete material, yeah, CDB15, CDB25. So I'm gonna bring those materials. So I'm gonna bring those materials here. So when you have a library, you can take it this also. I can automatically add it, and you can see my material is frame concrete CDP. And it's 2.4 e density, and the elastic modulus is this one. And this is a calculation. It takes so much time. In case if you don't know how to get the CDP, there is some a vape tool. Then you can put your compressive strength and modulus, compressive strength, and then you can create this data. And also concrete damage plasticity model. We have some default parameters you can change in, such as viscous parameter, and just this one, and also dilation angle can be 30 to 45, this one, and the compressive strength will be calculated yours. So this is the maximum part 15, and in case if you want to list, if you want to see a curve of this, then we can create x y data. So the x is, this is plastic inelastic strain, so that should be number 2, and the red one, so we can call it strain curve. So I'm gonna save it. So I created one, and later you can come to the last part of the in the model. You come to the in the last part, maybe in the job, in the visualization here, and you can see we have one x y data plot. So I'm going to plot it, and you can see this is the curve which we provided for 50 megapascal concrete. So we go back to the property, and we have these two material, and next we should define some a section. So the first section is concrete, and this is homogeneous. This is the module installed and going to here and taking the material 50 millivolts. And again, I want to use I want to use called E rebar. E rebar. So we have two a way to define the rebar. So one is a beam and one is truss. So there is sometime in case in the concrete reinforcement we're not looking for the actual force or some other things. So just we wanna see the impacts of the both reinforcement and also concrete, just stress and strain. But in some we can actually do both in truss and also beam. If you use sometime truss, so then you change in the mesh the type of element should be truss. And if you use beam, so then you have to define some cross section. So I can do both, and the result is same, and there's no different. So I want to use beam, so we call beam, and then this beam required a cross section called. We go back here, and this one is a rebar of 10 millimeter. So I'm gonna give R10. So this is a circular, continuous circular, and the radius should be 5. So we're using millimeter, so this is 5. And remember, when using meters, so it will be very small. You should be very careful about this. So the material is this one, and you can change it, give again the portion ratio here 0.3, and okay. And we go back again, and this is also we section 3 is gonna be ES bar. So means existing straps bar. So the same, and we go to back again. That was 10, and we're gonna using rebore 6 millimeters, and the same we give a 3 millimeter thickness. Again, the material, and we're using 0.3. Now we finished the section creation, and now we want to assign those to the existing elements. I'm adding to the straps, so that's E straps bar, and then go to E rebar and assign, and the last one is concrete. Now the material is assigned. One more thing that you should remember, otherwise you will get error. You have to define one orientation when you have a beam. So I'm gonna add as it is, because in any direction the section is same, but if case is rectangular or other section, so that will be some differences. Okay, and the straps is going to be is also be assigned, and okay. So you will not get error. So in case if you want to view this right now, you can go to view. It's called part view, view here, and view option, part display option. You can come to here, and you can just call the beam rendering and apply. So you see here is the rendering of that. So default, apply, okay, and we go to the assembly. In assembly, we bring the column, okay, apply. And we bring that E straps there, okay. And we want to bring that, so we can rotate this one. For the time being, we're not going to change anything else. Just we want to take this and rotate it. So you can use this command, it's called rotate instead. And so we're gonna rotate across the Y. So select instant, first select instant, and then giving a 1 to Y, so call 0 and 1. And select an endpoint 0, 0 and 90 degrees, so automatically it will come here. Now we can here is some command that you can use during this one, and this one it can help you to recognize the elements, and also you can using this command as well. So if I go back here using this one and using this one is maybe meta. So it's exactly here we can change the color to different called part, so you can see different parties here, one white, one red, one green. Now the next thing is that I'm going to turn off this one or the concrete column. You can select this one here. There is another method you can come to play from this one also from tool, and it is called paths, and I'm going to call them remove it. Or you can use the command here, select that command and just call remove. Now again I'm going to see it here and select, I want to select but I want to move it, translate this one. So this translation will be going to be in our Y by 0 point by 20 millimeters, in the X come 20 millimeters, in the Z 20. So now select 0 0 and going to be in the Z shall come to positive positive direction, this direction, this is the X come to the positive, and the Y should be in a negative, should be in a positive as well, and in the Y positive up, in the X this direction, and the Z this direction. So totally all positive direction. So now you can see here, if you will rotate and the location is here. Now I wanna populate this across the corners. I'm gonna give this one it's 260 here, you can see 260, and also we wanna take the same 260 in another direction as well. If we go back here and you can see totally they are here. We using 250, that 10 millimeter is the depth, should be inside, is much more logical like this. And that should be 250. Now the last we want to rotate, translate the these straps as well. Select this one and select these straps, and we again considering the same 20, 20, 20. That should be 0. Oh. No. We first select 0 0. Okay, 0 0, and then we give the end point should be 20, 20. Now we can see it's correctly placed, but we did one thing wrong. So that was the one thing was wrong, especially we cannot get back that this is 260 and we extended 250, and because this is lower, so we do again this one. We're gonna rotate, select that instead, and taking 0 0, and this time we bring it down a little, and but we pushing a little in the Z direction. Okay, just select an endpoint, should be in a X. We're not going to shift anything. 0 in the Y, we're gonna reduce by 10 milli, and in the Z we wanna put in about this 50. You can see now it's better. So this arrangement is based on the giving detailing of your reinforcement concrete column. Now I want to use this command. It's called path linear pattern, and we select this one, and I want to add it. You can add as much as you want. So I'm gonna select this direction, and this one is be 0 1, and let's giving 20 centimeters uniformly, and we wanna populate to the entire column. So this one is okay, the last one, and I'm gonna say okay. So this is the first, and now I'm gonna use this command and called replace all. So everything is here inside, and you can see. So if I go to use this command, it's called undo, and it should be here. So one thing I wanna make it, I wanna make one thing, and I'm gonna come to tool and creating a seed, and it's called rebars. So it will give me one thing later in the instruction. I can use it. Now the assembly is completed. We also can do some rotation. So let me do one thing, and you can see it. I wanna make some rotation that the column should stand. But it's okay. We can stand this column and rotate by in the X direction, and okay, select instance. And then we selecting 0 and going to rotate in a X, which is 1 and 90 degrees here. If I give negative, so that will be up. So now this is okay. We can take this one and rotate, translate. And taking that point to 0 0. So now here we are, and concrete, everything is quite good. Next we go to that step. We can conduct a dynamic and also static analysis as well. We can consider some damage criteria as well. But we take a sample, we're using a static called static. We're taking general static, and here is the important things. So we use nonlinear, you can consider nonlinear, and you can activate this one and take the time period, let's be 5 or 10 seconds, and the incremental be, let's be 10,000, a large number to. That the 10,000 increment can finish that 10 seconds. So initial be 0.1, and the minimum be 1e minus 15. So a large number, a small number. If you use this method, and you will not get any error. So the maximum can be 1. If you use this one, and you will not get any error. So be careful on use considering the incremental. It should be automatic. In case we give this initial, the program will Seek which one is which incremental way can convert the analysis. So okay, and okay. Next, we can go to the output here, and because it's concrete damage material, we should create that failure criteria: damage, compressive damage, tensile damage, and scholar stiffness degradation as well. So okay. And okay, now we can go to the interaction, and we want to create embedded region for the concrete and concrete rebar. So now using this embedded region, and it's called select embedded region, so I can select the concrete frames. So it's called select normal select region, and I can pick up that sets which I already defined here. And now the so first in the first we go back again, and embed region should be select region. So I use rebar first and then dismiss and select a host region. So the host region should be rebar. So this is rebar, and the other what should be mode solid elements or select region, and just select this. Now you also can play with this one, but it's, at default is okay. Okay, so now we created the embed region as well. So one more thing that I wanna create some reference points, some other stuff. That I can apply load and also take this some output in that point. So the first point is that I want to create a create a reference point in here, or yes, I want to create a reference point. That's what make it easier to get the actual force in that point. So I can use here, but before that I'm going to create a point between these two. And now again one in the top, so this is quite in the center of the column, so we load the structure concentrically, and there is no any movement that we should apply. And next difference is here. Now I want to create some contact. So I can use MBC, I can use coupling, I can use tie. So if one of these cause error, so that you can actually take another method as well. So I'm going to use for this one, I'm going to use coupling. So I'm going to control point, and now it's required me to give the surface. I can give the surface of the concrete, and then this is kinematic. Yes. Next, the same thing we'll do in the bottom of the concrete column, surface and surface. So we are finished here, and now we go to the loading. Loading. We will, instead of applying the some force, but we're going to apply some displacement to evaluate the column capacities. So then we will improve that column, and then we will again recheck and see how much improvement is made. So we can come to first here and create a boundary condition. So brought me to this boundary condition, this one is called fixed boundary condition. If you remember the in the structure, top and bottom is in the real project, top bottom is actually fixed. So we can use this method, and we select that point and that reference point, and I'm going to fix it in these three dimensions. Some rotation can be allowed, and next we doing the same called top. We select the top button and then we use X, and we just considering Y should be giving a minus 20 millimeters. So 2 centimeters when we're compressing, so the concrete will break. So we the 20 millimeter is okay. So now you can see here the support location is like this. Now we finish here, we go back to the step, and we want some particular data, some particular point should give us a specific output. So I'm gonna call a reaction force and a displacement, so RU, and selecting this point. And now I go to the story output. So when we apply that 20 millimeter, and they giving a force reaction which is equal to the bottom. So I'm gonna call RU, reaction force and displacement. So we measure that displacement from the top and also reaction force. You also can get any point you want. So yes, in the same and set, and we're gonna call RU, and so every n increment n is okay, and we wanna displacement in the y direction, vertical direction, and we also wanna take the RDF too. So we created one story output as well. So we finish loading, we go to mesh, and we should come to the part, and we should mesh here. And so we can use this simple. Okay, and then we're gonna go to mesh. And next rebar. And the last one is this column. This can be 100. Or maybe we can give it 50, a little fine mesh is better. Now we finished meshing, and I should tell you one thing. In case if you use trace element, then you come to the here called the sign element type. So you come, it's automatically the program will take beam, but when you come trace, you should use trace elements. So that is a sign. Now it's completed, and we go to the job. So we create a job, and we can call it existing column analysis. You can, in case if you have a different computer, you can use bring some changes here, use multiple process. So I'm keeping default here. Submit to the analysis. So after submission, I'm going to see here the status of the analysis. In case if there is an error or any problem, we can solve it. Now it's running, so we can see some error. The system matrix has to negative. It's okay, no problem. Just we wait until that 10 second is finished. So after that, we will check the analysis and the result part. The analysis almost completed. Just a few steps left, and so we can receive the completed. Yes, 10 seconds, and you can go to dismiss here. and it's called completed. So we go to result, and we can visualize the result. We go to here, and this is the last step, 10 seconds, and the stress is reached 250, which is already yield. So we can go to here, and we wanna see the just see the report. Let's see what we're gonna see here. Place it, and this is the report stress strain, and we can change to some plastic strain. We also just can see the deformation. Unit is millimeter, is 25 millimeter almost, and we can go to back part and we can replicate with the column. So here is the column. So you can see some compressive damages happen here, which it has a large deformation and or buckling. Now we can see the concrete compressive damage, mostly damage here close to the loading area, and the concrete damage, the tension damage is also this area. But displacement 2 centimeter is not too much large displacement. In case if you go 30, so the entire column will be actually deformed and also damaged. Now we can quickly do a visualize animation to see in each step. So here and bottom, here, here. So mostly the loading area, which is the actuator, is here when they're pushing the structure down. So the damage will occur here. Okay. Now we can go to the output, story output, and we already defined some field output. Was we can come to back here, create story output, and there is too much, but we can especially giving the these two displacement and this two. We can save it as it is, and you can see the curve, how the curves looks like. So we will operate this curve, and we're gonna create a XY. The displacement should be in X, and the actual force should be in a Y direction. So one more thing, if I draw this one, it will be in a down, and save it. I can call it FU, force displacement. I'm gonna go plot it, plot expression, and it's down. So this is the zero and it's going to be down. So what we're gonna do is we just come here and we create one more, and this time we wanna times by a negative sign combined. We wanna clear again, combine, and a minus one times in U, and then we give dash again minus one times RF. We're gonna save it again. If the force displacement, so I'm gonna plot that one, and this is in a positive direction. So this is the concrete column response, because the actual force when it reached to this is almost 120 kilonewtons, 120 kilonewtons. So automatically dropped, and then the in this level the steel rebar will bear the force, which is the core area. So so this is the response of that column force and a vertical displacement. Now when we add the second part, which we another concrete jacketing, so we will compare with this curve again. So now you can export this curve as a Excel sheet or something else. You even can plot it here, and you can get the data as you wish. You also can check it this one here, double click, and you can bring some changes, especially in the line size and the color size, everything else. Okay, this is the first part, and the second part we will add the concrete jacketing to the existing column.